What is up, guys? Marcellus Williams, aka the Swolefessor, here to educate you on health, fitness, social being. And during this video, guys, I'm going to be showing you what my Wednesday and Thursday workouts look like. Most of Thursday is going to be raw, but I just want to kind of take you guys through on what these Wednesdays workout look like. Like I said, Wednesday is pretty much the only day that's not structured like in a full body setup kind of way. This day is pretty much just focused on direct back work, which makes sense since my Tuesday workout is like a volume focused squat, bench, deadlift variation day. Everything's pretty much getting a lot of love, except for the back isn't getting a whole lot of direct work. Like, it's getting worked when I do the sumo deadlifts, the Romanian deadlifts, but on this day I'm doing some actual pulling and rowing motions. So for the lat pull downs, I had, you know, a top set of 12, then a top set of 10, then a top set of 8, then the same thing with seated cable rows, top set of 12, top set of 10, then a top set of 8, just increasing the weight every time. I'm just focused on, you know, properly overloading the muscle groups, so, you know, trying to increase the weight a little bit for each set, each session every week, while making sure that I'm getting that nice full protraction and retraction on my rows and protraction and depression on my lat pull down. So keeping in mind the function of the muscle group just as much as overloading it. And then after that, I had base pulls focusing on external rotation. It's really hard to do these properly as far as getting that external rotation when you have like a short rope, but the long rope, I couldn't find it anywhere. So I'll try to probably go to a different gym next time to ensure that I get one. So I was holding the rope at the very end just to try to ensure external rotation as much as I can. But this is 3 sets of 15. And then after this, I have TRXYs on the TXR setup. I wasn't able to do that at this gym, but I'll definitely show you guys that, what that looks like next time. Just another good upper back movement. But then to finish off on this day, I have a superset, 3 sets of 15 of a curl of choice with a press down of choice. So I just did strict barbell curls with 60 pounds and then supersetted that with, I want to say, 90 pounds on the cable stack machine. Now, one thing I will say, guys, when it comes to doing like any type of like machine-based work, especially like with cables, try to be consistent with the gym that you go to, for the mere fact that the different stacks will weigh differently. I'm sure you've all experienced with like 90 pounds at one gym may feel different from 90 pounds from another. So it's kind of like, oh, how can you ensure you're progressively overloading? Just be consistent and kind of make sure you use the same machine at the same gym. And that kind of alleviates that problem for the most part. But yeah, that's pretty much what this day is focused on. It's just getting some direct back work along with a little bit of arm work, which makes sense because on my Sunday workout, even though, like I said, that's kind of set up like in a full body style manner as well, it's pretty much more bench and back focused as well. So having this day just ensures that I'm hitting my back directly like twice a week with proper rowing and pulling motions, keeping that body part nice and strong. And like I said, the rest of my days, I'm pretty much hitting everything else evenly. Now, this is the beginning of the Thursday workout, which you guys know Thursdays are my church area day. So it's just like, you know, the third day of the week where I squat and bench press, along with like, you know, just doing some active recovery and technique based work, which you guys are gonna be seeing that I take you through as far as all my accessories as we go through the raw portion of this video. And I'll also be explaining to you like, you know, what the set and rep scheme is for the squats as well as the bench press. But I pretty much wanna finish this voiceover by going over like what I'm doing here specifically, which you guys notice is high bar squats. Now, the reason I'm doing these is very similar to the last time I incorporated them during my prep leading up to my last meet, is just to, once again, I'm focusing on keeping that upper back nice and tight, which is the same cue I use for my low bar squats, but it's also a lot easier for me to keep my back extended with the high bar squat compared to the low bar squat. It just allows me to stay more upright, not to fold quite as hard in the hole. And that's what I'm really trying to build up right now. Just build up that movement pattern. And even though I'm thinking about on the low bar squat as well, it just allows me to do it today on this high bar squat without my body feeling like overly tight and locked up from having already comp squatted twice that week already using the low bar style. And in addition to it, it just feels really good like on the quads, just a different type of engagement on my quads. It allows me to get a little bit more pop out of the hole. And you guys already know that during this off season, aside from like, you know, working on all these different variations and thinking about these different cues and functions to improve on the big three, I'm also just trying to build overall size as well. I'm chilling around like 160, 162 right now, trying to build up to 170. And as a whole, I definitely want to build my entire body, but you guys already know that I'm really emphasizing, I'm trying to bring my legs up. Like, I feel like, you know, all in all, pretty proportionate, not the calves, we ain't talking about the calves, but I just want to, you know, I want, when people look at me and I tell them what I bench, they look at that chest and they know I ain't lying. When I tell them, you know, how much I do for weighted chin-ups, they're a little bit shocked, but they look at my back long enough and they know I ain't lying. But I want people to know when I say, yeah, I'm over here squatting 450 plus, pulling like, you know, the mid 500s, I want them to look at my legs and be like, you know what, bro, I know you ain't lying. So that's kind of like, you know, something else that I'm thinking about when I'm going in here doing these high sets of 9, even though it feels like death by cardio, I'm just thinking about the fact that, hey, this is all gonna help you with building up to your goal of having some nice, thick, crispy, dark brown turkey legs. But yeah, that's pretty much all I want to talk to you guys about with this voiceover. Enjoy the rest of the video. Sets of nine. So pretty much, as I probably mentioned the voiceover guys, today is my church area day. So even though this is like the third day you guys are seeing, technically, keep in mind this is technically my fifth training day of the week, because my week starts on Saturday. So it goes like my heavy days are Saturday, Sunday, volume based work is Tuesdays and Wednesdays, and then Thursday is my technique focus, active recovery, kind of additional volume day. And so I only have to work up to a single top set of nine, but I have to do build up sets all the way up to there. So you guys saw I did like, you know, 220, 242, 265, 281, and then finish off with 292 for my top set of nine at RP6. So yeah, that was fun. What I'm pretty much focusing on with that is just back extension. Like I told you guys, I'm really trying to cue back extension, external rotation, all that good jazz, just so that I can have it carry over into my low bar position as well. Now for bench press, I have to work up to just one top set. It's the same thing, but I do build up. So I'm doing build up singles to a single at RP6, but with a 3 second tempo eccentric. So the point of this is to still kind of keep heavier loads in my hand, just because such a weird thing to say, keep heavier weight in my hands on the bench press, just because, as I mentioned to you guys before, even though volume is going to be the key to really, like, you know, building up all your lifts, especially the bench press, just having heavier loads in my hand is beneficial for me, just for the amount of weight that I'm lifting due to my body weight, so that it doesn't feel so foreign when I get back into working, like, you know, with 300 plus pounds, I can always have that. But since it's like the church area, kind of after recovery day, we have that 3 second eccentric, so I'm just still focusing on technique, control, properly tensioning it to my chest, pressing off the power, and it's at RP6, so I'm not just overexerting myself too much on this day. But anyway, yeah, sorry, guys, I'm spinning. Let's get to it. So I thought 275 would be about like the RP6, but it felt like between like a 5 and a 6. I sent it to Brendan. He says like a 5.5. He wants a true 6. So went up by 10 pounds, a little 286. Let's see how this goes. Y'all, man, that felt good. Bench, it's coming back. Bench felt so crappy, like that entire like prep leading up to this past meet, but then it felt really good on game day, and ever since then it's just been feeling great. Keep in mind, this is like my most fatigued day, like it's the last training day of the training week, so hitting 286 at like a RP6 or a single, and it honestly felt even that might have been a little bit sub 6, but don't tell Brendan that, you know, he'll see it when he watches the video. But anyway, bench felt good. Anyway, now we're gonna move on to the accessory work. I have like single leg
RDLs, goblet split, no, just normal Bulgarian split squats, and then like some core mobility work. So like you guys know, just the usual kind of like recovery, tertiary day type of activities. All right, guys, so my first accessory movement for today is single leg dumbbell Romanian deadlifts. Really, it's more like a staggered stance Romanian deadlift. I'm not gonna actually just be on one leg. And I'm just focusing on properly hinging at the hips, maintaining a neutral back. Once again, cueing a lot of back extension and back neutrality, just to work on that movement so that I can keep that when I'm doing things like, you know, my conventional deadlifts, my squats, so on and so forth. So that's definitely something that I feel is like harder to do with my left foot forward. So that's something I have to work on as far as like kind of like the imbalance between that. It's not even so much that I can't go as far down, but it's going as far down as I do on my right side and keeping that back in a more neutral position. Granted, that could also be due to the fact that I do my left foot forward like after the right foot. So the lower back and everything as a whole may just be kind of fatigued. So I'm gonna take a little bit more time between like each side, but that's the gist of what I'm doing with that. So I'm gonna blast through my next two sets and then show you guys the Bulgarian split squats, which you guys have already seen before. My whole focus with that is pretty much just keeping my my knees stacked, my torso nice and upright, back neutral. The same thing you guys have seen me do before. Alright guys, so next I have pull off press. So pretty much what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be pulling this cable out. I'm gonna be in this position. I'm gonna be trying to press it forward. As I'm doing so, I'm trying to make sure I maintain this position. So what is gonna happen is this, as I'm pushing forward, is gonna wanna like twist me. So I'm having to fight against that while coming back and pushing straight forward. So it's really gonna fire off my core, especially the oblique area. So bridges give me all kinds of fun stuff that's gonna suck at first, but I'll get better at it, master it, and build up, become the key of accessory work once more. Alright guys, so that's pretty much it for the video. I intended to show you guys kind of like my mobility circuit, the new mobility circuit that Brendan gave me. It's weird, so on this church area day, I actually do it at the end. On all my other days, I do it at the beginning, but I promise I'll show you guys that in one of the next like workout videos. I still have like two more training days to actually show you guys. It's just, yo, even with explaining like the accessory work, man, my energy level was just not there. I really underestimated how much those build-up squats for sets of nine were gonna like gas me. So, bro, I came in here, it was a little bit later. I got here maybe around like 8:20 or so. It's almost like 11 o'clock now, but it's like, I came in here just like, oh yeah, man, I'm pumped, man. I got two videos out this week, about to get this third one out. Energy's high, gonna, you know, explain these guys, you know, keep it simple, specific, scientific, do what the Swolefessor does. Did that first set of squat, and I'm like, it's all good, it's still gonna be good. By the time I got to that last one, man, I had no gas though, so I apologize for that, guys, but don't worry. I'm gonna get back on it, make sure I train a little bit earlier in the day, come prepared for these type of like, you know, longer sessions. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead, leave a comment down below, let me know what you did. If you're not, leave a comment down below, let me know what I can do better. Like the video, share, subscribe, keep it simple, specific, scientific. I'll catch you later.